plaintiff, Audrey Thompson, says she and the defendant became friends with benefits after meeting online. And a year into their relationship, Audrey became pregnant. Audrey claims when she told the defendant, he requested a DNA test, but then he kept dodging the test. So she petitioned the court for one today. Defendant Antoine Besson says when Audrey said she was pregnant, he was shocked because she told him she couldn't get pregnant. Antoine insists Audrey is the one who's been avoiding the DNA test, so he is eager to find out the results today. He's countersuing Audrey for harassment.
All rise. This court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Greg Mathis presiding. You may now be seated.
Give me some background.
Antoine and I met a couple years ago through an online dating site.
We were 15, 16?
2015, I believe. And we had an adult situation. We were friends with benefits. Neither of us anticipated a pregnancy or wanted one for that matter at the time. So about a year into knowing one another, I became pregnant. And I informed Antoine, and like myself, he was very taken aback by the situation. During the pregnancy, he did express that he would...
Why do you think he was taken aback?
Well, because we both are nearly 40, and I didn't think I could medically have children. And so we
didn't... At age 40?
Yeah.
Who told you that?
Thank you. My doctor, I have...
Your doctor told you you're 40 years old, so...
Well, no, not because of my age exclusively. I have PCOS, one fallopian tube.
Another,
I have a medical condition.
You got another health challenge. Got it,
yes.
Now.
So during the pregnancy, though, he expressed that he would like a DNA test when the baby was born, which I agree with, wholheartedly, because our situation didn't warrant for him to believe that the child would be his necessarily, because we weren't in a relationship. We lived in different states. We just seen each other for our adult activities, and that was it.
Hey, for a year, though.
Yeah, but twice during that year. It wasn't, a regular thing. Also, like a month before, the actual conception, which, I knew afterwards, but there was another man who could have been Mason's father, our son's father, which I now know isn't because I already had him DNA tested. So now I know the conception was, in fact...
How long ago? This was a couple of years ago.
Our son is almost 18 months old.
And you're talking about how adult you are. Out here having sex, friends, benefits, and no protection?
Yeah, it was foolish. It was absolutely foolish, and I definitely learned a lesson.
And it wasn't just him. That's my point.
No, it was both of us. We're both adults. We both
And
knew.
The other person, too. The other man.
No, the other person, he and I went and got tested together before we were ever intimate.
I'm referring, you went to get tested, and you were concerned, and so was he, because you had unprotected sex like you did with him around the same time frame. You don't understand the concept, huh? Of if you don't have protected sex with anyone, there's a likelihood you're going to get pregnant. That likelihood increases when you have an unprotected sex with two different people at the same time. Do you understand what I'm saying now?
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
Okay. All right, so what has he said at this point? Have you asked him to get tested and what did he say?
Oh, absolutely, yes. I set up one DNA test situation, and Antoine just kind of disappeared after that.
When?
This was when our son was about 6 months old, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And then I recently spent out of my own money, a couple hundred dollars, getting an at-home pregnancy test, for Antoine to come down and take, because we live in different states. And, he said he was going to try to come, then he couldn't come because he didn't have a car.
How recent was that?
A couple weeks ago.
Okay.
And I'm surprised y'all even got him here today. And I truly, truly, on behalf of myself and my son, appreciate y'all taking us on. And because, our son is biracial, and our son deserves to know all of his family, not just my side. And, and it's unfair to our son if he gets to an age where he's aware of things to know that he has this man saying, well, I don't know if you're my baby. I can't give him culturally and of his identity what his father's family can.
So you don't think that your family can teach him how to be a black man? And you
Absolutely.
Are right. But however, you might send, you got that one girl. Rachel something, another, in the NAACP.
And she said she was black.
She said black is a state of mind, and she may be on to something there, I don't know. Rachel.
I'm sorry. And yes, I wanted to submit to you a picture of our son, if I may.
And Rachel, I'm on your side. I don't want you to get the other impression. If your state of mind is that you're African-American or you have blood in you, as such, come on in. We together.
This is our son who looks all me in the face, all his daddy in the body.
All right, sir. What do you say? Give me your background information.
Like she said, we are met on the dating site. And we connected on the phone, and we connected to the point where we wanted to meet each other. So we met, and you know, like she said, in a year, two times in a year. So the after the second time that we meet, a week later, she called me like, we got a problem. What problem do we have? She texted me, showed me pictures of a pregnancy test. First of all, you said you couldn't get pregnant. You know, then
said she couldn't get.
She couldn't get.
Yeah,
there's no health. I'm like, oh, well, after a week, how do you know that you were pregnant? Like, what have you missed?
It was 5 weeks.
Like, I don't understand here. You know, like, wait a minute, hold on. First and foremost, you know, I want a DNA test. You know, and
that's what you asked for.
Yes. Oh, yes. First and foremost, you know, so I want to do
that.
And
that was in 2015.
Yes.
All right.
You know, so throughout the pregnancy, I addressed to her that I wanted a DNA test, and she understood that. So the plan was, once the baby was born, we had a DNA test at the hospital.
That's not true.
That was the
whatever the plan was, ma'am. Yeah, it's 2 years later, so he's got
it.
2 years to go. Go
okay.
ahead.
That was the original plan. So after when she had the baby, she go through her pregnancy. I wouldn't even notify the baby was born until after the baby was born. So I go, whoa, wait a minute. I thought we originally agreed that we would take the DNA test since it was the easier way at the hospital.
Correct.
And she said, well, I didn't want you to come because you weren't there through the pregnancy financially, and
that's
my family
true.
Was, and I didn't want no commotion at the hospital. Like, what do you mean? This is our kid. We're trying to set the paternity
up.
Speed
up to the next opportunity to take a paternity test because it's been 2 years mm-hmm. since that time.
Okay. Now, after she had the baby, and I said, okay, what's up with the DNA test? Mm-hmm. So first, she told me it's complicated. Oh, you mean it's complicated? Like, I just want a DNA test. So she's been giving me the runaround on the DNA test. She has been giving me the runaround on the DNA test.
All right. And you've requested one how many times since the hospital?
Oh, countless times. So at least I count on one hand 10 times.
Man?
We agreed. I believe I brought it up that we should get DNA because of our circumstances. The only way DNA could have been done when Mason was born is if somebody would have paid
Ma'am,
for that.
Ma'am, he said he requested 10
times.
Oh,
he probably did.
And you come in here acting like he's a bad guy. He's done something to you. He's been trying to take the test. As you just said, I hope if he's the father, you don't play those money games with him.
That's a
which happens a lot. Oh, you ain't giving me no money, so you ain't going to see the baby. You wouldn't let him come to the hospital because he wouldn't give you any money.
That's not
you
true.
Just said, yes, it is. Let's see the DNA. And your counterclaim for $3,000. Is for what?
Well, due to the whole situation, she posted an ad on me on my whereabouts on Craigslist, Facebook, Grouphub.
That's false.
All right, so how's that harassment?
She got a picture. She got my pictures.
Oh, she was trying to find you. I was not
missing. She been in contact with my mom through the whole thing. I've never missing. Never missing.
That's not true.
Yeah, she's been in contact. I have evidence right here that
she's
been in
contact. Why can't she contact you? You said mm-hmm. you reached out to her 10 times.
I have.
Did you give her a number?
She has my number.
Those 10 times.
She has my number. My number has changed.
So
in,
what
in
does
December.
She say on Facebook looking for you then if she has your number?
I have no idea.
Ma'am?
Thank you. First, the thing on Facebook, his screenshots will show, wasn't me. It was a friend of mine trying to intervene into the situation. Second of all, me and his mother have been in somewhat contact. I sent her recent, you know, pictures and updates on the baby because it's her grandchild.
All right, I'm just dealing with this harassment.
Okay.
Him saying you put
that is her being contact with my mom. This is
what is it? That,
my friend put a thing without my consent or prior knowledge.
Here's Facebook.
Yeah, sir. This is somebody else.
No, that is a fake account. That is her. That's a fake account. She have done this before.
How can you prove it's her?
No,
because it says another name.
But she have done.
Can you prove she's done it before?
That is wild.
Yeah, have you done this before? Watch
no.
This.
Yeah, she have done this before.
All this dodging, I know you the daddy. All this game plan, I don't even have to open that up. When they come across like you are today, that's daddy. That's a yes. What, ma'am?
I just wanted to say that he's had opportunity to take the DNA. He evades it and
ma'am,
then
be
says,
quiet. He asked you 10 times. He asked you 10 times.
And he's
nobody
had three
wanna hear that. Y'all go and work this out because he's the father just like I knew. Have a good day.
I just really hope that now we can co-parent and you'll be in Mason's life and we can move forward.
Now that I know that I'm the father of this kid, you know, like mm-hmm. this is the first time I'm hearing that about another guy, but it's the first time I'm hearing about another guy. So now that I know that I am the father of this kid, mm-hmm. I can be a father to him.